The President of the United States, Barack Obama, has condemned the bloodshed in Libya and says he's studying a range of options to put pressure on Colonel Gaddafi. His comments come as countries around the world evacuate tens of thousands of their nationals caught up in the chaos. How do Libyans living in the UK feel watching this event almost from the sideline, what's happening in their country? 25-year-old Abdul Ghafoor Khalid joins us on the show this morning. Abdul, thanks for being with us. Good morning.
Yeah, no problem. Good morning.
How do you feel? I mean, there you are. It's your country. You're away from it at the moment. And you've seen these terrible events unfold. How does that make you feel, first of all?
Well, obviously, I mean, you feel upset about what's happening there in Libya, but you also feel just as upset about the fact that you can't do anything at all to help them other than go out on the sort of general protests that they have been doing over the last few days in London and other cities of the UK. It's just very difficult to watch from the sidelines. We do sort of keep in touch with my uncles and aunties back in Libya, and they report to us sort of what's happening, but I mean, one has to bear in mind the fact that many people are very worried about reporting over the phone and over the internet and over Skype and using the internet to report what's happening. There are, you know, various sources which are reporting stuff, so I think a lot of the time we're not even seeing the full picture of what is happening because not everybody's reporting what's happening. It's very difficult to deal with it here.
There's a fear, isn't there? I mean, there's an air of fear about reprisals. And as you say, people are frightened and, exactly. And always have been frightened to speak out. In
I mean, I think Gaddafi has made it very clear, even more clearer than previous leaders who've recently left their posts in the Arab world, that he will go all the way. And I genuinely believe he's telling the truth this time. He will go all the way. He will fight till the last bullet. He's obviously at the moment using many foreign mercenaries. I think that's because of the Libyan army have actually laid down their own arms and that. But I think it's going to be a very, very tough fight, especially for those living in the west Libya.
Do you think he's a man? I mean, a lot of people are saying exactly what you're saying there, that because of that, he's a man not to be underestimated because he's deliberately weakened his army so that the army couldn't rise against him. He's brought in mercenaries from North Africa who have got no allegiance to the country but a heck of an allegiance to Gaddafi. He's no fool, is he?
No fool. I mean, he's got a cocktail of dictatorial experience, if you like. He's been there for 42 years, so he knows how to play the game very well. And like you said, I mean, that's the way he came to power, through a military coup. So like you said, he's weakened the army, and he's definitely playing the game very, very well. And there will be a bloodbath. I mean, either there's two options. Either there's a massive bloodbath and he finally leaves his post, and him and all his family, or there's a massive bloodbath and he stays in his post. So either way, there is going to be a very lots of reprisals, regardless of whether he stays in his post or not. And it's just a case of the protesters sort of keeping the momentum, but at the same time gauging whether or not how far it will go. To be honest, I think, you know, personally, I believe he should definitely go, and so do many of the people in Libya. But one has to bear in mind the fact that, you know, there is a massacre going on, and to at least initially accept the fact that there will be many casualties and many...
It's interesting, because somebody was saying the other day, or I read somewhere, there's lots of coverage about this, that the reason that it's different from Tunisia and different from Egypt is that you know who all the players are. They're easily identified. But in Libya, what Gaddafi has done, he's got this network of people who, some are his family, some are people who have been paid off and been given gifts by the regime. We could be having a conversation, and I wouldn't know where your allegiance really lay, and you wouldn't know where mine... And that kind of fear of you don't know who the state is has served him well, hasn't it, over the last...
Yeah, it has. I mean, I think Libya's the only country where there's so much one person in charge. I mean, with Egypt and with Tunisia, and that, you have a sort of parliament, if you like, and you have, you know, parties, and you have known people, for example, Egypt, Mohamed Bouredi, and other opposition leaders. But with Libya, there is nobody except for him. And at the same time, he says that he hasn't got a role. So it's very, very different to both Tunisia and Egypt. And I think that sort of frightens people as well, because Gaddafi has been threatening about the state of Libya if he does go, and saying, well, there's nobody else, and what are you going to do, and it's just tribes and that, and it's deliberate that he's done that, as you mentioned. It is frightening as well.
And on a personal level, I wonder, when you came to study here, how did that freedom, that ability to be able to express how you feel, without any fear of reprisals. How did that work for you? Did you find that difficult to express that freedom at first?
I think it is. I'm limited because I want to keep my connection with Libya. Just the other day, yesterday, I was speaking with my auntie in Libya, and you could sense the sort of vagueness she was talking in, and even though I'm living here at the moment, the freedom, I can't take advantage of the freedom if I want to keep contact
with... If you ever want to go back, is the reality of it, isn't it, really?
Yeah.
Listen, we wish you and your family well. Keep in touch.
Okay, definitely.
Thanks for joining us this morning. Fascinating insight to Abdul Ghaffour Khalid joining us on The Breakfast Show this morning.
BBC Coventry and Warwickshire.